Approve na gabi po sa inyong lahat, mga kaibigan. Ako si Elaine Fuentes at inaanyayahan ko po kayong samahan nyo kaming muli at tulungan kaming tulungan kayo. Sama-sama nating tuklasin ang mga pamamaraan tungo sa mga palatuntunan, proyekto, programa ng gobyerno, maging ng mga pribadong ahensya at organisasyon na sadyang ginawa po naman para sa ating kapakinabangan. Ibahagi naman ninyo ang inyong reaksyon at suggestion sa ating email at fanpage na naka-flash po ngayon sa inyong mga screens. Makilawak na kaibigan, ito ay programang para sa inyo. Dito walang alinlangan dahil dito ituturo namin ang mga pamamaraan. Ito ang approve. Gawin natin to. Sa maraming mga balita, araw-araw, sa ating mga nasasaksihan pag tayo lumalabas ng bahay, merong nagtatanong, may pag-asa pa kaya ang bansang Pilipinas? Puro kasi mga bad news. Di ba dapat hanapin naman natin yung mga good news, yung mga serbisyo publiko, mga public servants na gumagawa ng kanilang tungkulin? Alam niyo bang mayroong isang organisasyon na ito ang layunin, i-push, i-encourage at ipasikatin yung mga public servants na gumagawa ng maganda. Nakipag-partner sila sa private sector at meron silang ipinupush na awards for this year. This has been going on since 2012 or 2014. Ngayon, meron sila uling pipiliin. Tayo ay katuwang doon sa pagpili na yon. Alamin natin kung ano itong programang ito. Pagbabalik na ang
Hi, I'm Coach Mark Solano, 3x3 Officer of Samahan Basketball ng Pilipinas, and I'm 1 with 25.
I will be president for all America.
Eagle News International Edition, Monday to Friday, 9 to 10 p.m.
Fuego!
Masipag, mapagmalasakit, mapagmahal, magalang, masayahin, at makadiyos. Ilan lamang yan sa may pagmamalaking katangian nating mga Pilipino. Tumating man ang mga problema, pagsubok, at kalamidad, madaling bumangon ang mga Pinoy. Ito ay dahil na rin sa pagtutulungan o tinatawag na bayanihan. Kilala rin tayong mga Pilipino sa mabuting pagtanggap o pakikitungo, hindi lamang sa ating mga mahal sa buhay, kundi maging sa ating kapwa. Mababang loob at di nagbubuhat ng sariling bangko kahit na nagkamit ng tagumpay o karangalan para sa bansa. Kaya naman sa paggawa natin ng mabuti, may pagmamalaki nating tayo'y mga Pilipino. Ako po si Sam Cepeda, naniniwala sa kakayahan at husay ng mga Pilipino.
Masayang umaga po! Lunes hanggang Biyernes, alas 5 hanggang alas 6 ng umaga.
May mga asosasyon na ang pangunahing layunin ay tumulong sa kapwa. Mayroon din namang marinig lang natin ang pangalan ay nakakapagbigay pag-asa na. Isa na dito ang asosasyong Kaya Natin Movement for Good Governance and Ethical Leadership. Ang Kaya Natin Movement ay nagsimula taong 2008 sa pangunguna ni na former DILG Secretary Jesse Robredo, former Governor ng Pampanga na si Mr. Edia Among Ed Panlillo at ang former Governor ng Isabela na si Ms. Grace Padaca. Ang kasalukuyang Executive Director nito ay si Ms. Amelia Malabag Hernandez na siya namang Vice Mayor ng Laguna. Ito ay may layuning mahikayat ang mga tao sa volunteerismo. Ang isa sa mga programa na ilulunsad ngayong taon ay ang Champions for Health Governance, Excellence and Governance for Healthy Communities 2017. Ito ay may layuning maisulong ang pagkakawanggawa ng bawat isa. Ang programang ito ay nakapokus sa pagbibigay serbisyo tungkol sa kalusugan. Kahit sino ay pwedeng makibahagi sa magandang oportunidad na ibinibigay ng asosyasyong nabanggit. Naway maging daan ito upang mas mabigyang importansya ang sektor ng kalusugan sa tulong ng mga pagkukusang gawa. Ngayong gabi, makakasama natin ang Kaya Natin Movement for Good Governance and Ethical Leadership sa isang oras na talakayan kasama si Ms. Elaine Fuentes. Ako si Ellery Husay at approve sa amin ang organisasyong ito.
Alright, thank you very much Ms. Ellery Husay and Ms. Weng Maduma for that video package. Alam niyo mga kaibigan, merong mga pangalan ng mga organisasyon and there are just some names that marinig mo pa lang yung pangalan nung organisasyon, nagbibigay na ng pag-asa. This particular organization that is involved in this big project for this year is such. Ang pangalan ng kanilang organisasyon, Kaya Natin. Okay? Ang ating pong kasama, si Ms. Amelia Ami Malabag Hernandez, Executive Director ng Kaya Natin Movement for Governance and Ethical Leadership. And she also happens to be in government right now. Yes. She is the Vice Mayor of a town in Laguna. Magandang gabi po sa inyo, ma'am.
Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat at sa mga nakikinig nanonood ng inyong programa.
Totoo pala yung sinasabi nila, magaganda ang mga dilag sa Laguna.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, ma'am, Kaya Natin Movement, just the term itself inspires hope.
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. Actually, when it was created in 2008, mm-hmm. By three people, founders, headed by our former Secretary of DILG, Secretary Jesse Robredo,
yes.
And then former Governor of Pampanga, Among Ed, Panillo,
yes,
and then of course, former Governor of Isabela, mm-hmm. Grace Padaka. So,
okay. Magkakalapit sila, no? Isang nasa Isabela, isang nasa Pampanga, tapos isang nandun
oh,
sa...
That's oh. Right. And convene, ang convener right. Noon is Mr. Harvey K.
Harvey K, of course.
So, yun.
So, the Mr. Harvey K.
Oh, kasi the time, gusto nila na magkaroon ng sanctuary, mm-hmm. na isang grupo, na lahat ng gustong maglingkod ng matino at mahusay in government, eh merong pagpupuntahan. Kasi minsan gusto mo lang maglabas ng sama ng loob mo,
right.
Di ba? And we wanted to create that time. So, si tatlo lang sila at saka si Harvey.
So, it's like to create the proper channel, no?
Exactly. We tap each other. Halimbawa, meron din problema. We remind each other. But
I remember this, itong kasabihan na I always try to keep it in mind during times of adversity. Di ba para daw magtagumpay ang evil, ang dapat lang mangyari ay manahimik yung mga nakakaalam ng tama.
Well,
for evil to succeed, all that needs to happen is for good men to do nothing.
Correct. That's right.
So ito yung part natin in doing something.
Yes.
Okay. So the complete name of the organization is Kaya Natin Movement for Good Governance and Ethical Leadership.
Right.
Okay, big words. Una muna yung good governance. Pangalawa yung ethical leadership. Pinagsama pa natin, di ba? Parang ambitious siya.
Right, that's
okay.
Right.
So, paano natin to conceptualize? How do we actually operationalize these two big theories or thoughts?
It came from three big E's, okay? Mm-hmm. So, it's effectiveness, okay. Effective in leadership, mm-hmm. empowering leadership, mm-hmm. and then ethical leadership.
Okay.
So, in other words, when we choose our members, kasi by invitation eh,
right.
And we actually invite those who are in government.
Mm-hmm.
So, kung pumasa ka dun sa tatlo, more or less, we will try to invite you and then look at you and how you can right. contribute more.
Right.
Pero kung sumablay ka sa isa, mm-hmm. katulad na nasa ethical,
right.
Medyo papark ka muna namin and we'll okay. wait and see if you are improving or not.
But papahinog muna. Papahilog muna, baka hilaw lang.
Correct.
Okay.
So people change and people improve and people do something also to improve themselves. So hindi naman namin itchapwera.
Right.
Park lang yan. Pagka medyo okay ka na, mm-hmm. we might invite mm-hmm. later on.
So itong good governance and ethical leadership, we simplified it through the three principles na
right.
binanggit mo. And then the first two words noong movement na ito or ng organization na ito, Kaya Natin.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi dito, towards the end of the program, I always say na gawin natin to. Kasi right. kaya natin to.
Correct.
That's why medyo may ring sa akin yung kaya natin to. Okay. And it's very hopeful, no? When it was conceptualized and until now, Mr. Harvey K. is one of the young ones also eh.
Mm-hmm.
Medyo tawag dito, nandun siya sa up and coming.
Mm-hmm.
And he has young children.
Yeah.
So I can understand where he's coming from.
Right.
And from previous conversations a long time ago, several years ago, sinabi niya na it has something to do with leaving a better world for the next generation.
Exactly.
You have a very unique position right now kasi mm-hmm. Pangalawang pinuno ka ng isang lugar sa Laguna. Saang town ngayon? Mapasikati naman natin.
Nagcarlan.
Sa Nagcarlan?
Yes.
Oy, matulaing lugar ang Nagcarlan.
Correct. That's where the underground cemetery. It's actually
right.
a national heritage.
Right.
And it's actually known for that place. So,
right.
Nagcarlan, Laguna. It's only about 1.5 hours from Alabang.
Okay, without traffic.
Correct.
Okay. Ngayon, meron din dun mga kakanin, di ba? Ano yung otop nyo, ma'am?
We are known for our espasol.
Espasol, yes.
Yes, and our espasol, our ube,
right.
our makapuno.
Right. Makapuno is
yes,
good also in Nagcarlan.
Right.
Okay. So, now, being the second in command, so to speak, sa Laguna. How do you focus muna tayo sa Laguna, no? The impact of Kaya Natin Movement for Good Governance and Ethical Leadership. May nakita na ba tayo na tawag dito? Parang personification, so to speak, doon sa Nagcarlan.
Actually, ang personification talaga ng Kaya Natin is when you get people involved
mm-hmm.
and volunteer
mm-hmm.
to do good
mm-hmm.
in the community. This may not necessarily come into being registered mm-hmm. sa Kaya Natin.
Right.
So, ang ginagawa namin sa Kaya Natin, we try to distribute ourselves
yes.
geographically.
Okay.
So, marami kaming Kaya Natin champions all over the country.
Mm-hmm.
And me, being in Laguna, I try to involve people
okay.
to understand and what volunteerism is all about, what is love for country is all about,
mm-hmm.
what is good governance is all about.
Mm-hmm.
So, with that tool in on hand,
mm-hmm.
lagi kong disseminate sa tao, sa information, na ito ang dapat natin ginagawa. Ito rin ang dapat mong asahan. Pag pumili ka ng isang tao sa gobyerno, lagi mong titingnan yung tatlong E. Pag sumablay siya doon, medyo, oops,
okay.
boboto ko ba to? Hindi. Parang
right.
ganun. So, those are the main points. But it all starts with good governance, doing your job well,
mm-hmm.
and doing it right. Parang mm-hmm. ganun.
Okay, so let's repeat the three E's nga uli para medyo magkaroon ng recall. E,
effective.
One, effective.
Empowering.
Empowering.
And ethical leadership.
And ethical leadership. Doon sa una, sa effective, alam na natin yan, self-explanatory. Doon sa empowering, can you elaborate?
That means that you, being a leader, should also be the guide for new generation.
Mm-hmm.
You should empower them to do good and to do good governance. No? So,
mm-hmm.
kailangan hindi mo sasarilinin yung natututunan mo.
Right.
You have to disseminate the information well.
Mm-hmm.
And while you do that, dapat natututo rin siya para pag siya naman, i-disseminate
niya. So, parang in the same principle as teaching them how to fish.
Exactly.
Okay, and the third one is?
Ethical.
Nako, yan ang medyo, ganyan yan eh. Ethical. There are, as time passes, medyo parang nag-evolve or namo-modify yung tinatawag nating ethics because ethics from like 40 years ago may not be exactly the same as the ethics now.
Correct.
So, ano yung pamantayan natin when we say ethics? Kasi usually pagka-ethics, may na-involve dyan ang values, ang character,
Damn.
Ang environment, and most of the time, religious beliefs also. So, how do we, it can be very vague. Eh.
Correct. That's
so,
right.
pag, if we are going to use that as a standard, it has to be precise. It has to be specific. So, paano natin specify ang ethical?
We just put it simply. Ano ang tama at anong mali?
Okay.
So, by the...
Black and white lang.
Ganun lang. Para sabi namin, ang tingin mo medyo tagilid at malabo at mukhang mali,
mm-mm.
there's something wrong already if you pursue it. Like,
right.
if you're doing a public service, alam mo naman na pag itinago mo yon, alam mong mali yun eh.
Right.
Pero, gagawin mo pa rin.
Right.
So, it's really a black and white of mali. And tama or
right.
tama and mali.
Okay. Eh, pagka ganyan ang ating pamantayan, madali na kasi marami tayong nakikita. Alam na maling na gagawin pa rin. So pagka ganon, dapat automatic din ang response natin as the people responsible for putting them in power, di ba?
Exactly.
Tayo naglalagay sa power. So three E's, okay, effective, empowering, and ethical. Okay, yan yung isinusulong ng Kaya Natin to.
Movement.
Okay, kaya natin to. Ang haba kasi ulit. Meron ng kodigo. Kaya natin movement for good governance and ethical leadership. You say that it is an invitational only group. So, pagka na-invite, what are the duties and responsibilities?
And actually, the process starts from somebody nominates this incumbent officer or incumbent
and it has
leader.
To be from the government service.
O, pwedeng yung ino-nominate?
Yes.
Oo. Okay. Sana, no? Pag na-nominate, then that person will go into vetting.
Okay.
So, pag-aaralan siya, i-background investigation, we'll check ano yung mga ginawa niya, if he's effective.
Right.
Empowering ba yung taong ito, based on the feedback.
Right.
Most of the time, sumasablay pagdating doon sa ethical.
Yes,
so, doon pa lang. Pero may lulusot. So, after the vetting process, it will be now presented to the plenary, to the membership, no? Na ito yung mga napili na from the vetting. So, may nalalaglaglag na. Okay. And then after that, of course, the final say will be the board of directors of Kaya Natin. If this will be named as the Kaya Natin champion.
Okay.
So, yun. But we are divided into the several groups also, right. No? We have the Kaya Natin champions and we have the core group.
Mm-hmm.
So, the core group naman are, these are volunteers.
Okay.
These are private people who wants to work with us and contribute their time and their talent with us.
Right.
But the champions are actually the ones that being vetted.
Right.
What are their achievements, mga ganon.
So we are into positive reinforcement.
Yes.
Okay. So we are.
I think we need that now.
You can say that again. Oh, kailangan natin yan kasi there are so many na we forget sometimes. And I'm so happy na Kaya Natin has put focus on this. Marami tayo lagi sanction sa ganito, sanction sa ganyan, kasuhan na yan, kasuhan na si ganito. Mm-hmm. So the focus is dun sa wrongdoing. While there are so many, and I repeat, so many, na talagang nasa puso yung paglilingkod. And because ang focus natin doon sa pagsuheto, pagsaway doon sa mga may ginagawang mali, which I'm not saying is wrong, tama din yon, pero paano naman yung gumagawa ng tama? And that's where Kaya Natin comes in.
Yes, we serve as a sanctuary for these people.
Right.
Kasi you will be surprised, may mga matitino talagang, maraming matitino.
Oh, I know. Oh, yes.
Na nawawalan sila, nawawalan ng loob. Kasi parang feeling nag-iisa na at nag-sosolo.
Right. So, sila ba yung outcast, no?
That's right. Okay. Yun nga na, outcast. So kami, Kaya Natin provides that sanctuary for them.
Right.
That hindi ka nag-iisa, Kaya Natin.
So kayo yung charging station pag nalulobat
na
sila.
Okay. That's right. That's
right. So Kaya Natin provides the battery for them to keep on doing what they are doing. Because when you are, the purpose of Kaya Natin is to reinforce those that are doing
it. Yes, that's right. That's
okay.
Right.
And you have activities throughout the year. I know because somebody I know works with you. so I know that you're very busy. And you are right, no? You don't just confine yourselves dito sa Metro Manila. Merong Togigaraw, Shai, is that correct? Togigaraw, and then there's Baguio, and then there are other places.
We're all over the place.
So we're all Filipinos here, notwithstanding yung regionalization.
Yes.
I know that there's an upcoming event and you have partners here. Ang Net 25 partner nyo na rin in some way because we are here promoting this particular program. Okay, so when we come back mga kaibigan, makasama naman natin dito, ano yung mga mechanics dito? Paano ba nila ito kinonceptualize? Medyo mahigpit ba yung pagpapatupad, policies and regulations dito. Ang magsasalita niyan ay si Mr. Michael Alzona naman, ang director ng MSD Market Access and Policy, katuwang ng Kaya Natin Movement. When approved, comes back, magbabalik po kami.
Saluhan ang ating itanghal, ang pambansang almusal, pambansang almusal, ang pambansang almusal, pambansang almusal.
Lunes
hanggang Biyernes, alas 6 ng umaga, dito lang sa Net25.
Eagle News International Edition, Monday to Friday, 9 to 10 p.m.
Hi guys, please watch Letters and Music Monday to Friday
1 to 2 p.m.
only here
on Net25.
Can't do it all? Do what you can. Caring for others. Pass it on.
Masayang umaga po! Lunes hanggang Biyernes, alas 5 hanggang alas 6 ng umaga.
And welcome back sa ating palatuntunan, mga kaibigan. Kanina nakasama natin isang vice mayor sa Dako ng Laguna at siya rin ang executive director ng Kaya Natin Movement for Good Governance and ano nga yung isa? Ethical leadership, lagi ko nakalimutan yung huli. Ngayon, ang kasama naman natin, partner nila, no? He is not necessarily from Kaya Natin, pero his company, he himself decided to partner with them para makatulong na isulong ang advokasya ng Kaya Natin. Ang kasama natin yan si Mr. Mike Alzona, Director of Market Access and Policy, and he also belongs with the MSD. Yes. Okay, what is MSD, Mr. Magan? Good evening to you.
Good evening po. Thank okay. you. Thank you for having us in your show. So, ang MSD po ay known as Merck also in the US and Canada.
Oh, okay.
And outside US and Canada, we're known right. as MSD. Right. We're a biopharmaceutical company. Mm-hmm. We discover, develop cures for unmet medical needs. So,
yes.
basically, you know, we make we discover medicines and vaccines
right. and do research. Okay.
Do research, yeah.
I am not familiar with MSD pero I'm very familiar with Merck.
Yes.
Oo, yeah. mas yeah. may recall sa akin yeah. ang Merck. And yes, there are a lot of medicine out there that was formulated, discovered, was a result of research
yes.
by Merck.
Yes.
And Merck is not stopping.
Yes.
Okay, it has become a global brand.
Yes.
Okay. So, kami ay maliit na bansa dito sa Dako ng Asya, composed of 7,108 islands during low tide. Bakit napili ng Merck ang isang organisasyon gaya ng Kaya Natin to partner with them?
Yeah. At MSD kasi we have core values, no, like any other organization. And one of our core values is ethics and integrity.
Mm.
And a global healthcare company like MSD, we believe that it is very important to promote ethics and integrity.
Yes.
Mahirap siyang intindihin, no? But I think for a company like MSD where we value very much yung integridad, the way we do things, mm. because at the end of the day, we do things for the patients. No?
Right.
So ito yung reason why we actually partner with an organization like Kaya Natin.
Mm-mm.
Kasi we want to promote good governance no?
mm-hmm.
in health in the Philippines.
Alam mo sir, yung ano, dun sa mga na-in-love na, tsaka in-love ngayon, meron tinatawag na MFEO. Alam mo yon?
MFEO.
Oo, MFEO. Yung mga dalaga dito na sana. Sige nga, challenge. Walang nakakaalam.
Men
sige.
For each other.
Yes! Sino nagsabi nun? Oo, men for each other. So, ibig sabihin lang, it's I'm joking, of course. Pero merong katotohanan yun kasi here you are, a company well-established all over the world and your operating core value is about ethics and health. Mm. And here comes, kaya natin to.
Yes.
Basically, doon pala sa pangalan nila, ethical na nga eh, yes, di ba? Yeah. Pagkatapos, meron silang programa about health governance.
Yes.
So, kumbaga parang pinagtagpo talaga kayo.
Actually, tama yan. No? Way back in 2012, no? Kung makwento ko lang. Before I joined MSD, I was with an NGO as well.
Oh.
So, my first love is really development work.
Okay. So, you were also placed at MSD so that part of your heart remained with the NGO. At nung nahan dyan ka na, humanap ka ng NGO, natagpuan mo si Kaya Natin.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And it was way back nga, in 2012, when I met Harvey Ke and Jess Lorenzo, who's the son of the late Mayor Sonia Lorenzo, who was one of the Kaya Natin champions. Nag-usap kami, nag-meet kami, and tinanong namin sila, paano ba tayo magpa-partner, no?
Right.
And how we can promote good governance in health. Mm-hmm. And dito nabuo yung programang ito, yung advocacy-ang to, where the both organizations agreed na it's about time for us to work together and promote good governance.
Oh, parang ano yan, si Kaya Natin ang right foot, tapos kayo yung left foot.
Yes.
So together, we go somewhere.
Yes.
Okay. Now, what is exactly the role? Ano yung pagiging left foot ng MSD dito sa kampanya na ito? What are you going to, what role are you going to play?
So this is actually our third run already of the program. Mm-hmm. No? So every other year to. So way back 2012 when we conceptualized, then 2013 and then 2015. So ang role ng MSD is really to help Kaya Natin promote the program by recognizing local government units who have demonstrated excellence in good governance, no? And then we are we are not focused on programs only, but on the way these LGUs have implemented these programs.
Okay. So parang ang gandang partnership, no, from the government kasi ang executive director and then she is involved in an NGO which is basically for the people, automatic,
yes.
No? And then you come from the private sector,
yes.
And a giant at that. Tapos pareho kayo ng isinisigaw.
Yes.
Diba? Pareho kayo ng message na gustong i-put forth. Sabi mo, this is 3 years running and this is the third year.
The third run, so every other year. So 2013, then 2015, and now 2017.
Okay. Question lang, and this is, I'm going to ask this in behalf of the Vice Mayor. Is there going to be a fourth run?
Yes, definitely. We are committed.
Alright. Naka may ebidensya ka naman na partner pa rin sila.
Partners.
Okay. Now, I'm very interested with this program, no, it's called Champions for Health Governance, and under that it says Excellence in Governance for Healthy Communities 2017. We are going to talk about that. What is this all about? Ano mapapakinabang ng taong bayan dito ng bansang Pilipinas? Ano din naman ang kumbaga shot in the arm para doon sa ating mga magagaling at mahuhusay at ethical na mga public servants when it comes to health service? Pagbabalik po ng approve, kasama natin ulit si Vice Mayor at si Sir Mike. Talakayin natin ang Champions for Health Governance.
There are 30 million young Filipinos today. When they are empowered, they can create a prosperous and sustainable future for humanity. How? Let's focus on just one girl. Let's call her Nina. Nina can fulfill her dreams if we give her the power to shape her own future. She can be an inspiring leader, a productive worker, an innovator, a caring parent, or a key person in her community. But without proper support and access to opportunities, her future will be at stake. That is why the United Nations Population Fund is supporting the conduct of a 15-year study that will follow a group of 5,000 10-year-old girls and boys from all over the Philippines. We want to learn the changing needs of Filipino youth like Nina for the next 1.5 decades so we can give them access to the best solutions. Because what the world will look like in 15 years depends on our power to unlock the potential of a 10-year-old today. Will you let their future slip away?
Eagle News International Edition, Monday to Friday, 9 to 10 p.m. Masayang umaga po! Lunes hanggang Biyernes, alas 5 hanggang alas 6 ng umaga.
There's always something about the spirit of volunteerism and wanting to do good, not just for ourselves or our family or our immediate community, but merong power dun lang sa pagkakaroon ng advocacy to create change for a vast majority, especially of the Filipino people. We all know that we could use all the help we can get. Together with us today, ang Vice Mayor ng Laguna, who also happens to be the Executive Director of Kaya Natin Movement for Good Governance and Ethical Leadership, si Ms. Amelia Amy Malabag Hernandez. Ma'am Amy.
Hello.
At saka si Sir Michael, but DC?
De La Serna.
De La Serna, okay. Española, Alzona, ang director naman ng MSD Market Sales, Market Access and Policy. We are going to talk about the collaboration of these two well-meaning organizations. And this is the Champions for Health Governance, Excellence in Governance for Healthy Communities. Okay, I know that the Philippines is not doing excellently when it comes to health in general. So I have an idea why you're pushing for this. I know, of course, why on your end you would push for this. But Kaya Natin, you want to encourage good governance.
On health.
On health.
Yes.
Yes. Tama ba yun, ma'am?
Tama po.
Sumakto tayo.
Exacto.
Okay, so I'm going to ask Ma'am Amy first, when and how was this conceptualized? Because there are so many aspects in our society, di ba? Mm-hmm. Bakit tayo nag-focus sa health?
We believe in Kaya Natin that, yes, good governance must also be tapped on health. Okay. Kasi kung hindi malulusog at hindi maganda ang pangangatawan ng ating mga mamamayan, we will not be able to have those good governance leadership, di ba?
Right.
Eh, wala namang makain. Nagugutom naman. Mm-mm. The health facilities are not working. So how can you have and tell them to provide good governance, ayusin natin ang sistema? Hindi naman sila well, or may sakit sila. So that's where we thought that for us to move forward and to shout that there's really good governance in our government, unahin muna natin yung health. So pagdating sa health, kailangan ang ating komunidad. When you have a community that is healthy, then you produce good leaders.
Right. I have to agree with you, Ma'am Amy, kasi we can be most productive when we are healthy.
Kasi pag gutom ka, masakit nga ulo mo.
Mismo.
Mainit ang ulo mo, magagalit
Mismo.
Ka.
Tsaka hindi lang yun sometimes, although we are not saying that it's an excuse, no?
Yeah.
Sometimes kapag ka hindi tayo nasa wastong kalagayan sa kalusugan, it gives way to some thoughts that are not pleasant.
Correct.
Okay, sometimes nabubuyo doon sa hindi paggawa na hindi maganda. Sometimes nabubuyo doon sa mismong krimen. So we have to take care of that first. Now,
Tama.
Sir, being the health industry yourself, do you subscribe?
That's why we're here.
Yes, we're partners. But as an individual, as you are, because you said you came from the NGO before, and now you are in the private sector, pero nandun pa rin yung puso mo. Ano yung I know that information dissemination and educational campaign is part of this.
Yes.
Part ng isinusulong ng inyong kumpanya. Mm. How do you think that this is going to help in doing that?
Yeah. Ikaw na nagsabi, di ba, na we're not actually doing excellently
yes.
On health.
Yeah, it's on record too.
Yeah, it's really a fact. No? Especially for a country like the Philippines mm-hmm. na devolve ang ating healthcare system
yes.
no nag-rely tayo sa ating mga local chief executives
right.
no and si Vice will agree with me I think no na nakita natin no na may mga LGU minsan ginagamit ang health as a tool for political interests
right.
no? Instead of providing health services
right.
papagawa ng basketball court, di ba? Pangalan. Ang health kasi hindi mo malalagyan ng pangalan.
Right.
And I think, but despite that, may mga local government units tayo who have been delivering good health services and programs to their constituents. Mm-hmm. And yun po yung goal namin is really to promote, to spread the good news that there are actually good practices mm-hmm. among our local government units. It's not hopeless. Mm-hmm. And there's
kaya,
actually
kaya
big
hope.
Kaya natin.
Yes,
no? And,
yes.
and this is really the reason why we're doing this.
These are actually initiated programs by the local government
yes.
units. In other words, right. kasi meron naman talaga ang DOH ng mga programs
yes.
for the
yes.
the government. no? But we will, in this program, we will recognize those programs na initiated nila. In other words, kinostomize nila
I like that.
On their own need.
Right.
So, kumbaga, hindi dinikta sa kanila ng gobyerno, gawin mo to, gawin to. Mm-hmm. Nag-isip pa pat sila on top of that, programs that will really address those things, needs nila sa kanilang community.
Yes. One thing that we seem to forget at times is that because we are a bunch of islands right in the middle of the ocean,
mm-hmm.
magkakaiba ng needs yung
right.
mga communities. And the best person who would know how to address those needs, yung mga local executives.
Tama. Yes. In fact, ang ating winner last awards no natin noon is from Del Carmen Surigao del Norte.
Wow.
It's a
medyo malapit-lapit ni Malayo.
I think it's
siya.
A fifth class or fourth class municipality. I'm so sorry if I'm not pero ang ginawa niya, naggawa sila ng ambulance na sea ambulance. Kasi they are separated by islands.
Okay.
So ang ginawa ni Mayor Kors, ang galing ng mayor nila. Inisipan niya na para ma-transport mo ang mga emergency cases, dapat meron kang ambulance sa sea.
Right.
Eh, kasi ang ambulance lagi sa land, di ba?
Right.
So, he thought of that program and that's why we recognize his community, his LGU, mm-hmm. for doing so.
Mm-hmm.
And by doing that, nalilessen mo ngayon yung mortality rate na namamatay dahil okay. hindi na
just because
dala.
Lack of access.
Correct. Uh-huh. So, yan yung isa sa mga winners namin na medyo ako favorite ko. Kasi talagang, nga, no, walang ambulance sa dagat. Diba parang, so yung mga may dedicated ambulance talaga siya na pandagat.
Galing, ano?
Oo.
Okay. Yeah,
magandang pinoint out device din, no? Just to add lang. We recognize here not the normally ang mananalo diyan mga cities
yeah.
mga first
kasi
class
mga
kasi may resources
mm-hmm.
sila no but actually we recognize the good governance no
mm-hmm.
kaya good governance siya iba siya sa mga ibang awards
mm-hmm.
because
hindi dito paingayan
hindi palakihan ng programa
right.
but it's
yes.
how you implement your program no
right.
how the local chief executives and municipal health officers work together
yes.
to achieve their health objectives
right. Right. Yeah. kasi opportunity nila ano na, kasi ibang klase nga yung sitwasyon niya, mm. puro island siya eh.
Yes.
So sabi niya, naawa talaga siya kasi dami na mamatay pagka panahon na kailangan i-transport. So that's a good, very, very good idea na nakita namin talaga. Mm. Initiative.
It's a feel-good thing nung sinight mo yung Surigao.
Mm.
And then, kasi marami dito, sino dito nakarating ng Surigao Challenge? Lapa. Kasi malayo.
Malayo.
Tsaka mahirap. At tsaka hindi masyadong maingay ang Surigao kasi mm-hmm. hindi siya katulad halimbawa ng Palawan. You know, say Palawan, kahit
tourist.
Worldwide.
Oh,
kailan mo na kahit nasa bundok siya,
right.
kahit nandun siya sa sulok, mm-hmm. nandun sa malapit-lapit na sa China.
Oh,
alam pa rin na
right.
part siya ng Pilipinas.
Mm-hmm.
But the situation ng Surigao can only be seen by the executives there. Kasi
right.
kahit sabihin na natin, kahit sino pa pinakamagaling na pangulo, kahit sino pa pinakamagaling na health secretary, may limitations lang
exactly.
pwede niya makita.
Right.
And for you to see somebody and a community so far away,
yes.
napon talaga sila doon.
Totoo.
And to see that they created this project
yes.
na ambulansya, that, you know, could possibly benefit siguro marami-rami na yung nasa 10,000. Mm-hmm. Pwede na siguro yun, mm-hmm. no, conservatively speaking. Compared to what, 100 some million Filipinos.
Uh-oh.
Maganda nga ito, no, kasi mm-hmm. parang it's an encouragement. I understand also na yung mayor na may mayor course, no?
Co-ors.
Hi, Mayor Co-ors in Surigao. Hindi naman niya ninais na magkaroon ng
Coro
award.
Coro.
Mayor Coro.
Coro. Nakapagatay ko pa.
Okay, eratum.
Sorry, Mayor.
Mayor Coro ng Surigao.
Patay ako. Patay ako. Hindi iba't na ba?
Di ba, akuin ko, akuin ko.
Akuin ko. Ako din.
Okay. So, nung kinreate niya ang project na yan, I don't think that she had in mind, no, magkaka-award ako dito or whatever.
Tama.
It's because she really wanted to serve the constituents.
Yes.
Okay.
In fact, nung na-recognize yung LGU niya through his leadership, hindi naman siya kaya natin champion. Eh.
Yes.
Hindi siya kaya natin champion.
Okay.
And after 2 years, saka pa lang siya naging kaya natin champion. So, it took a while also.
Yeah. Right.
Kasi magaling talaga yung ginawa niya doon. So,
okay.
Kinostomize niya kasi yung kanyang bangka.
Right.
Wala ka naman nabibiling bangka ng ambulansya.
Right.
So, yun lang ginamit niya. And for a fifth or fourth class municipality, that was something that we recognized.
Yeah, it's a beacon of hope.
Wala siyang budget eh.
Right. Pero nagawa niya.
Correct.
So, hindi pwede.
Correct.
Isa pa yan sa motto namin dito, hindi pwede. May
that's
paraan
right.
yan.
I agree with you.
And I like that you mentioned na merong mga health policies. Hindi ako kumbinsido kaya may ganun. Yung sabi mo, nagpatayo ng basketball court. Brought to you by, di ba? Parang commercial break lang eh. Brought to you by. Tapos, pagka malapit na election, nandiyan na yung magme-medical mission.
Yes.
Nandiyan na yung magpapakain ng, sa mga bata, magpapainom ng gatas, at magpapavitamins daw. Tama. Pagkatapos ng election, wala na uli yung mga bata. Tapos, mamimigay ng PhilHealth card kasi mag-election, good for 6 months, mga ganun. So, that's precisely what we do not want.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Kaya ito yung ipinupush ng kaya natin. Ito, meron akong kodigo dito. Nakalagay dito objectives. And one of the objectives is to ensure that the achievements and best practices in local health programs are not only identified and adopted locally, but are also shared and spread across the country. Yung kay Mayor Coro, coastal communities natin. Mm, ang
yes.
dami haba ng coastline natin.
Oo.
So, I suppose, itong thought na ito can be applied
to the rest,
in other
to
municipalities.
Sana ma-inspire yung ibang LGU na mga right. nandun sa kaganong klaseng sitwasyon. We'll also do the same.
Right.
Actually, Del Carmen is just one of the winners.
Mm,
no?
Ilan nga
so,
yun, no?
So, noong 2013, lima sila.
Lima.
Okay.
2015, another five.
Okay.
And 20, this year, we hope to award another 5 local government units.
Okay, the more the many.
Yes.
Okay, so let's talk about the particulars of the award itself. Kasi sabi mo 5 yung ina-expect natin na manalo. How does one get nominated? Who gets to nominate? And what are the things na kinakailangan gawin para ma-nominate?
Mm-hmm. First of all, we launch it formally.
Mm-hmm.
Together with our friends from the government and
yes.
of course the powerhouse of MSD was there
yes.
and DILG was there. So we launched it first and we invited the local government to units to apply,
okay.
no? to present what mm-hmm. they have in their area.
Right.
And then our people from Kaya Natin will go to those places and validate and to see whether mm-hmm. that program that they have for their community on the health will be qualified for the program.
So, direct, they have this, no, or something like this. It's an application kit. Lahat ng mga rules, regulations, and things that you basically need to know about the Champions for Health Governance, nahandito. But for clarity, is the criteria too strict?
Well, it was intentional nga daw.
Okay, I wanted to hear that.
Yes.
No, kasi para mapatunayan natin, this is not just, you know, an award that you buy in recto and you
yes.
give away.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And we really highlight it.
Mm-hmm.
And besides, if MSD and other partners will provide the reward
mm-hmm.
for them to continue with their programs,
right.
dapat strict talaga.
Okay, so I'm not going to go too much into the details. We're just going to go to the awards criteria kasi this is simple enough, no? There are two main divisions for the criteria. One is good governance, which comprised 30%. When we say good governance, what exactly are we talking about?
Well, ano ba, magbigay ako ng example. Mm. So, kung may program ka na ano, hindi mo naman ibinibenta yung gamot.
Okay.
So, o kaya naman, hindi mo ipinapocket yung mga things for the people, right. Hindi nawawala. Logistically wise, you have implemented your health programs in your community. Mm-hmm. You have really adopted what is supposed to be a service for the people.
Okay.
So, parang ganun. So, in terms of health.
Yung leadership mo.
Yes,
leadership.
And transparency is important.
Okay.
Transparency and accountability are two important tools that they are applying. So, kita.
Okay. So, both hands on the table.
Yes.
Okay, wala sa likod yung isa.
Correct.
Now, let's go to the second major division in the criteria, public health governance, which comprised 70%. Of course, kasi yung ating title, Champions for Health Governance nga. Mm-hmm. So, public health governance. Nakalagay dito may effectiveness of health programs. How do we gauge effectiveness?
Well, the people, our staff or the representative will visit and see.
Okay. At may handro ng MSD because syempre health eh.
Yes.
Okay.
Parang merong immersion program talang pupunta. Tapos they will stay there and look at it and interview. No?
Hindi pwede magkalokohan dito.
Right.
Okay.
Validation.
Right. Validation.
Okay, innovativeness and health programs. Yan, i-explain na natin kanina like yung dun sa ambulance. Kung ano yung kailangan yun na dapat pinoprovide.
Right.
Okay, alangan mo magbigay ka dun ng 4x4, puro dagat dun.
Correct.
Okay,
that's
unless amphibian yun, no?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, he was actually, Mayor Coro was dreaming for a helicopter. Sabi ko, dream on.
Dream big, why not?
Yeah.
It's free.
Right.
We shoot for the stars.
Correct.
Case. Sa pangatlo is health resource management. Ibig sabihin dito, yan yung ano, pinagtatanong-tanong, the resource part. Kasi, hindi naman tayo mayaman.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, kung paano yung minamanage yun.
Exactly. Okay. And then how he is very transparent if he uses the resource. So, kung maliit na nga, hindi ka pa transparent, di patay na tayo doon. So, it has to be transparent.
Oh, it's biblical din, di ba? Pag mapagkatiwalaan mo sa maliit na bagay, likelihood mapapagkatiwalaan mo sa malaking bagay.
Totoo yun. Totoo.
Right. And the last part, community engagement in health. This I like. Kasi meron dyan mga local government, sorry po ha, tabi-tabi po. Eh, parang sila na nakakaalam ng lahat. Tama. Hindi na tinatanong yung kanyang mga constituents. Mm-hmm. Eto ba to?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
That's
all
the
right.
one. People you involve the people. That's people participation.
Okay. Mm-hmm. My next question is, who can nominate? Sino pwede mag-nominate? Ano ba ako, nakita ko yung, meron akong nalaman na mayor doon, nagtanong-tanong ako, mukhang okay naman siya. Do I have a right to nominate?
Well, you can nominate. You can send us an email, mm-hmm. kaya natin. Or we actually invite all LGUs to apply.
Okay. And halimbawa, kasi walang kuryente, walang internet masyado doon, hindi nila masyadong alam ito.
We use our champions.
Ah.
Our champions are scattered in the Philippines.
The whole archipelago.
Yes. So, the beauty of social media.
Okay.
Palagay ko medyo nakakaabot-abot na rin.
Mm-mm.
So, that's one tool.
Right.
And of course, your program.
Right.
You are
very
helpful.
We are global.
Yes, I know. And these are the tools that we really appreciate that we can, you know, share this program for the others to see and apply, no?
Right.
In fact, we have extended our deadline for submission. I think it's February 17.
Okay.
So,
pwede ba habol-habol?
Pwede bang habol-habol? So, we welcome the LGUs to submit their application so that we can process it immediately.
Okay, Sir
Actually,
Mike.
Actually, ang Department of the Interior and Local Government also issued out a memorandum, circular all local government units about the program.
Mm-hmm.
So, isang tulong din yan para ma-inform, no, even mga ibang LGUs tungkol sa program.
Ini-encourage ng DILG. So, lahat kami ng mga nasa local government units, napadalhan kami ng DILG ng letter na please apply.
So, walang excuse.
Yes. Okay,
andyan sila, avail
right,
na yung programang
right.
ito. Okay, I wish we had more time because this is a very interesting conversation, but we do not. So, I'm going to give you, ma'am, a few moments para address ang ating public to invite them, both for Kaya Natin and for this particular award giving project.
Una po sa lahat, maraming salamat sa approve, no, for the time that you have given us. I would like to invite our local government units, yung mga mayors po natin dyan at mga vice mayors. If you think and if you believe that your health program is really different and is really helping your constituents well, please contact us at Kaya Natin Movement for Good Governance and Ethical Leadership. We have a Facebook account. We also have our email addresses. So check us out at mga website po namin. We'll be waiting for you at sana po mag-submit kayo. We look forward to working with you. Maraming po salamat.
Maraming salamat, Vice Mayor Hernandez. Sir Mike, you have this unique opportunity through your company to partner with an NGO to help our local government units. And here, dito sa Aprobo, holistic ang tingin namin. We always try to look at the big picture. Yes. And we can see that through the assistance and partnership of the private sector as yourself, things can happen. Yes. Things can really happen. Siguro ikaw naman, sir, for those young ones, because you are part of the young generation, siguro your message to them and for the other private sector members, yes. What we can do, because it's not just about money, right?
Yes, that's mm-hmm. right. Okay. So first of all, thank you again for having us here and this opportunity. Sabi mo nga, this is a very special actually opportunity to partner with Kaya Natin, and we're very fortunate, no? We're very blessed, no, sa MSD at naging partner kami ng Kaya Natin dito sa advocacy yan to. Ang message na lang namin doon sa mga bagong henerasyon, hindi hopeless, no? It's not yet hopeless. There is really hope, no, working with organizations like Kaya Natin is one way of actually saying may pag-asa ang bansa natin.
Yes.
And help us, no, lalo na yung mga kabataan, no, help us promote this program, because I think sila yung pinaka-powerful ngayon,
yes,
no, in terms of information dissemination. So help us spread the good news. Okay. So thank you again sa approval.
And yeah, thank you to both of you. I support you because I think of last count, we have 20 million young ones,
yes,
in the country, and 20 million is 20 million. Yes. So if we can influence them, if we can convince them that they can actually be a force for good, we are in good hands. We are,
yes,
going to be in good hands. Congratulations,
yes,
to Kaya
Natin. As I always say, Kaya Natin to.
Kaya Natin to. Yes, we can.
Yes.
Okay. Hindi po ako nangangampanya kay Trump. Okay. Tapos na, but here, local parlance, Kaya Natin to. Yes, we can do it if we decide to do it. So congratulations,
thank
to
you
Kaya Natin.
Thank
it was
you.
An honor to have you here.
Same here.
And I hope this is not the last time.
Yes.
Laguna is just around the corner.
Yes, you're invited to come to Nagcarlan, Laguna.
We will. And Sir Mike, congratulations to you and to your company for choosing to do good.
Thank you.
Here in the Philippines.
Thank you
very much. Maraming
salamat.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Mga kaibigan, natin pong nakasama si Ms. Amelia Ami Malabag Hernandez, ang Executive Director ng Kaya Natin Movement for Good Governance and Ethical Leadership, and she's also the Vice Mayor of Nagcarlan, Laguna, Espasol. At si Mr. Michael De La Serna. Okay. Alzona, Director naman ng MSD Market Access and Policy. Mas kilala natin dun sa pangalang Merck, but they have partnered with Kaya Natin for this program called Champions for Health Governance, Excellence in Governance for Healthy Communities. Do not worry. We are going to flash on your screens the contact details ng Kaya Natin at saka nung kanilang secretariat for this event at saka yung kanilang website, pati yung texting. Lahat-lahat na ibibigay namin sa inyo for your inquiries. Okay? All right, thank you very
thank
much,
you,
ma'am.
Thank you,
thank you,
you
sir.
Thank you, thank you.
And
very
I hope
much.
To see you again.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Magbabalik pa rin ang approve.
Salamat.
Hi, I'm Joy Oliva.
I'm Maris Makula.
I'm Genevieve Asumbra.
From Puerto Princesa Bureau, you are watching Net 25. We are one with 25.
We'll be right back.
masipag, mapagmanasakit, mapagmahal, magalang, masayahin, at makadiyos. Ilan lamang yan sa may pagmamalaking katangian nating mga Pilipino. Tumating man ang mga problema, pagsubok at kalamidad, madaling bumangon ang mga Pinoy. Ito ay dahil na rin sa pagtutulungan o tinatawag na bayanihan. Kilala rin tayong mga Pilipino sa mabuting pagtanggap o pakikitungo hindi lamang sa ating mga mahal sa buhay, kundi maging sa ating kapwa. Mababang loob at di nagbubuhat ng sariling bangko kahit na nagkamit ng tagumpay o karangalan para sa bansa. Kaya naman sa paggawa natin ng mabuti, may pagmamalaki nating tayo'y mga Pilipino. Ako po si Sam Cepeda, naniniwala sa kakayahan at husay ng mga Pilipino.
Eagle News International Edition, Monday to Friday, 9 to 10 p.m.
Kaya natin to, napakasarap pakinggan, nag-i-inspire ng pag-asa. Ibig sabihin although mahirap yung mga circumstances, meron pa rin tayong magagawa para sa kabutihan, kaya natin to. So we'd like to thank our guests for doing this para sa sambayan ng Pilipino. At tayo naman bilang mga mamamayang Pilipino, gawin naman natin yung ating part. Kung maikwento lang natin na meron palang ganitong programa ang isang private organization together with the private sector, malaki na yung maitutulong natin kasi ang ating pamalakay ang ating naika-campaign ay good news. Sabi nga ng mga kabataan ngayon, good vibes. Kaya tayo nakaka-contribute na rin sa development or progress ng ating community. Wala na po tayong oras mga kaibigan. Approve na isang oras. Kasama kayo. Tandaan ito yung programang para sa inyo. Tuwing Martes ng alas 8 ng gabi, kami po ay inyong makakasama at your service. Ako po si Elaine Fuentes at ito ang Approve. Gawin natin to.